It is the biggest overhaul Australia's military has seen in decades, and it's come not a moment too soon. A deep dive into our defence capabilities has revealed that our nation is not war ready. In an era defined by regional tensions between Washington and Beijing, the country's Army, Air Force and Navy will need billions of dollars to bring them into battle preparedness. The federal government cutting projects to pay for its immediate priorities.
Australia is entering the missile age.
We confront the most challenging strategic circumstances since the Second World War.
But our defence force isn't up to scratch.
For the first time in 35 years, we are recasting the mission of the Australian Defence Force.
Not fully fit for purpose is the conclusion of a six-month review into the Defence Force, highlighting the need for defence capabilities to be bolstered across land, air, sea, space and cyber, diverting resources away from disaster response.
Through this review, are planning for tomorrow and the future.
The federal government outlining six priorities: nuclear subs, long-range strike capability, upgrading our northern bases, innovation, recruitment and cooperation in the Indo-Pacific, costing $19 billion over 4 years. To help pay for it, 33 current projects will be gutted, delayed or scrapped, saving $7.8 billion.
There is a huge degree of urgency in terms of the action right now.
The rest is already budgeted for, but beyond 2030, spending will need to increase.
There is no new money, and we're cannibalising capability.
The budget allocation is pretty much steady as she goes, but the rhetoric is of circumstances we haven't faced before in 80 years.
Over the next 3 years, the focus will be on acquiring and manufacturing long-range strike missiles, taking the Army's maximum strike range from 40 kilometres to 500 kilometres, while also upgrading our defence bases.
Our northern bases are a huge asset and a huge opportunity. That's the place from which we can project.
They'll need to recruit thousands of Aussies. It won't be an easy task, with workforce challenges grappling the nation.
We completely understand the training that is going to be required here.
This declassified version of the review doesn't shy away from mentioning China by name, criticising its ambitious military build-up for a lack of transparency and reassurance to the Indo-Pacific of what its end goal is, concluding a business-as-usual approach is not appropriate.
So we need to be more resilient. We need to have greater control over our national sovereignty.
Stella Todorovic for 10 News First.